all the way down here at Best Buy. That line is so long. Literally so long. I'm about to be hopping into that. So hopefully I get whatever it is that I'm here to get. Yeah, which you guys will see in my haul video, which will be after this. So, I hope you all had a good Thanksgiving, because I did. I had a bunch, and I'm really tired. And I'm not even going to get to watch my Cowboys game while I wait in this line. So, hi, Travis.
Hello.
We're in line now, and it's all the way up there.
Oh, is that for me?
Long way. Wife is here, too. Say hi.
Hi.
Miss Wifey over here decided to spend a lot more than I expected at Old Navy. A lot more. But we're almost done with kids' Christmas shopping and anything I could have possibly ever wanted. And everything that she could have possibly ever wanted. And yeah, that's Christmas. Target's line, by the way, is ridiculously longer than Best Buy's. Like, I mean, it literally wraps around almost all of their aisles. Like, ridiculous amounts.
Then let me know how much
I face. Jesus. But here's some of the cart goods. Yeah. Getting Splatoon for the kids and Lego City The Chase Begins. And soccer ball. Anthony's really getting into soccer. We got him some beginner books. But he wants to start taking soccer, and I also got him a crew shirt, Columbus Crew shirt today. So, it's going to be a pretty good Christmas for them. But, we might keep vlogging. We might stop at the mall. We were going to stop at Toys R Us, but then I was just like, we already can get all that at Target, so there's no point. And I've already ordered a bunch of stuff from the Disney Movie Club and Amazon book-wise, so... Yeah, kids got a lot of money spent on them this Christmas. Hey guys, welcome back to Back Pocket Game Reviews, and I know it's been a little while since I've made a video. Sorry, last upload I think was the day before Thanksgiving. I work retail, so this whole weekend has pretty much been chaos, because almost everyone ran their Black Friday deals through the whole weekend, which was a little bit tiring. But I did go out Black Friday shopping, as a good chunk of you probably know. Some of you who follow me on Twitter saw me tweet out where I was going and saw me tweet out what my haul looked like. The haul actually grew from where that was throughout the weekend, because I decided to pick up other things that I originally didn't think I was going to get. So let's start off with what the biggest thing was, because I did poll you guys on Twitter and ask if I should get the PS4 Pro or the PS4 Slim, and I stated it was only $150 price difference, not including the games. It was more after you include the games, because Slim came with a couple games that I was planning on picking up anyways, but nonetheless, I have a 4K TV now, and I have an Xbox One S. So I picked up the Samsung KS8000. And I got a 60-inch version of that, and it is glorious. It is extremely heavy because it's mostly all metal, but the HDR and everything about that just looks beautiful. So I have the Xbox One S, which can already upscale to 4K and has the 4K Blu-ray player and the HDR, whereas the PlayStation 4 Slim only has HDR. No upscaling, none of that stuff. No 4K Blu-ray player. PS4 Pro doesn't have the 4K Blu-ray player either, but I did decide to go with the PS4 Pro, which I will be reviewing on my channel as soon as I get the chance to get that all up, which some of you may know that I have done a video prior to where I kind of bashed on Sony a little bit for the stance and the way that they approached the PS4 Pro, which I will still stand by. I don't think they should have ever said its competition is PC. But my opinion may have changed. So let's start with the games after that. Now that you all know I have the PS4 Pro, I picked up a bunch of games for the PS4, because obviously it's a new console. I don't really have anything for it yet. I got Until Dawn, because I was really excited for that. I really like Heavy Rain. Kind of want to get the Heavy Rain Beyond Two Souls bundle, because I never got to play Beyond Two Souls. So you should let me know what you guys thought of Beyond Two Souls, and if I would like it. I hear it's not as good as Heavy Rain, though. Uncharted 4, which this and Until Dawn were two of the biggest reasons why I bought a PS4. Don't get me wrong, I still like my Xbox better, and there'll be a video on that coming too. The Last of Us, because when I had a PS3, I actually sold my PS3 right before this came out, so I never got to play it, which I'm pretty excited to. Infamous Second Son, because I really liked the original Infamous. I thought it was a really good game, so I was pretty excited to get to play that. Killzone Shadowfall, because I actually like the Killzone series a lot. I wouldn't say it's a Halo killer. I don't think anything's really a Halo killer, but it's a good game. I haven't played this one yet. Very excited. This is like one of the only things I picked up at GameStop, by the way, because it was $9.99. Sorry, guys. I still have a cough, too. Ratchet & Clank. I heard this was really, really good, so I was kind of... I like the old school ones, so we'll see how I feel about this one. The Uncharted Collection, because again, Uncharted is probably my favorite Sony exclusive game. And I would probably say it's easily their biggest exclusive game. Then I also picked up Titanfall 2, which is the only game that isn't opened yet, because I haven't had a chance to install it. I got this one at Target. It's on sale at Target for $30. I don't feel that was a bad price for Titanfall 2. And then I picked up Rainbow Six Siege, which I already have played a little bit of. And it's pretty good. This was $15 at Target. Most of the games I bought for the PlayStation were $15 at Best Buy. Except for Uncharted 4, which was 40-something is what I spent on it. And then Killzone Shadowfall, which, as I said, was from GameStop. And that's my Black Friday haul. But I also bought some stuff on Cyber Monday, so you all get to see the Cyber Monday stuff, too. God of War 3 Remastered. I'm going to give God of War another chance, because it was $11 new, and that's pretty hard to beat. And this is mostly because of the update that came out, but I picked up No Man's Sky. So hopefully that update makes it feel less like a polished turd, and I will feel more happy about it. I'm not going into this expecting, though, for it to live up to the high expectations that it had. Then I stopped at Vaporfy, because I like Vaporfy. But Pineapple Pal, they're doing 30% off the whole store, and they lowered the price on their Grand Reserve juices. So that was like $17.99 minus 30%, so like, what, $4 off? Maybe a little over $4. It's a pretty good deal. That's less than what I pay for a regular bottle of e-juice. And then I also picked up one of their ones. It's Grandma's Dutch Apple Pie. And they actually teamed with Cosmic Fog for that. But that's really good. Like, really good. Like, ridiculously good. If you vape, you should pick it up. I got a pack of coils, but you don't really care about the coils. And then the other thing I got was I don't have, like, a drippable device, so I hate the eyedroppers, and I prefer the normal tips, but they sell these now. So all of Grandma's Dutch Apple Pie is now in this tube, and it allows me to be able to prime my wick now before it. So that's nice, because I used to have to use one of my regular juices to prime the wick with the way that mine gets primed. So... But I hope you all had a great Black Friday and a wonderful Thanksgiving, because Thanksgiving is like my favorite holiday because it's based around food and I like to eat a lot, like more than what people expect someone my size to eat. Could be because I have a tapeworm. Don't really know. But been like that my whole life, so I would assume it's not a tapeworm because I probably would have seen some symptoms of a tapeworm, but none yet. So... I do apologize for that brief gap of no videos there, too, guys. I just had to kind of recover. I'm really enjoying the PS4 Pro as well, especially with the 4K TV. And you'll find out more about that when I finally review it, which I don't know if I want to pit it against the Xbox. It and the Xbox One S would be kind of an unfair comparison. But we'll get into that, too, in the video. So, guys, if you enjoyed this video... Give me a thumbs up. Just drop one of those thumbs up down there. Again, let me know how you felt about Beyond Two Souls down in the comments. And let me know how your Thanksgiving went. I'd like to hear. Maybe you guys got some awesome deals I didn't know about on Black Friday. But yeah, it's, you know, it's been a blast, guys. And I'll have plenty more content coming up for you soon. I got a lot of videos now in the chains and in the works. So I'll see you soon, guys.